Summarize is a very commonly used function that performs two operations. It scans a table and can do a group by, if you specify grouping by columns, and the grouping by column can include columns in the same table or in any related table. And it can also create new columns which are added to the output. In this first example, I'm using Summarize to scan the sales table. This is the starting table. And I group it by product brand and date calendar year. Both product and date are linked through sales through a many-to-one relationship. And that is the reason why we can use these columns in order to do the grouping by. The result contains the brand and the calendar year for only the brands and the year that are referenced in the sales table. You can also use Summarize to create new columns. In this example, I'm summarizing sales by brand and by year, but then I'm adding two columns, quantity and brand and year. Whenever you specify a new column, you need to provide the column name and the expression that defines the column value. What makes Summarize unique is that the expressions of the newly created columns are computed in both a row context and a filter context. So Summarize creates a filter context with the values of the column that you are grouping by, but it also creates a row context that lets you evaluate the values of the current row of this dataset. Indeed, you can see that I'm computing here quantity using sum of sales quantity, and the result is different for every row because this is evaluated in the filter context of the given brand and year. At the same time, I can reference product brand and calendar year, which are the two grouped by columns, because Summarize also created a row context that let me evaluate those two values. The presence of both a row context and a filter context makes the calculations and the output of Calculate very hard to understand in case it is not exactly what you would expect. This is the reason why we strongly discourage people from using the newly created columns in Summarize and instead split the grouping by with Summarize and surround it with add columns to create columns. Columns only creates a row context, and the debugging and the understanding of the values returned by add columns is much simpler. Using Summarize, you can also compute subtotals. In this example, by using the rollup function, I'm summarizing sales, I'm grouping by brand and calendar year, but the presence of rollup means that I'm also interested in the subtotals. You can see that in the result, I have the brand, the year, exactly as before, but I have also additional columns, Contoso with a blank for the year, which is the subtotal for Contoso in any year. And I also have a final row that contains blanks everywhere for the column, for the group by columns, and this is the grand total. This is especially useful when with a single query you want to retrieve not only the values of the individual cells in your report, but also the subtotals at any level. Finally, another feature that is unique of Calculate, of Summarize, is that you can use Summarize to group by calculated columns on the fly. Here you see that I'm using add columns to iterate over sales. I'm computing the sales type column as a newly created column that contains an expression, if quantity is greater than one, it's large, otherwise it's small. And then I can use Summarize to group by the sales type column. The result, small and large, is the amount of all the sales that have a quantity greater than one or equal to one.